To download your recordings off of Pearl, you simply need to use the admin UI and go over to the recording tab on your program that you want to download, and that's where you see all the recordings. You could also download your recordings for your program or your channel from Epiphan Live. Now, automatic file upload is a feature of Pearl that's really wonderful and easy to use. You can automatically send your files to servers, or you could even download it to a USB stick or a external drive if you have one connected directly to Pearl. And we'll show you all how to do that, and let's get started. Okay, so here you can see my recording tab for the program channel, and right here is where all of my recordings for this channel are listed. I can just click on any of the recordings I want, and if I select download selected, those files are going to download right off of Pearl onto my laptop. Now, if I wanted to use Epiphan Live, I would just click this link, and under the menu, select the recordings tab. And here you can just check any of the recordings you want to download and select the download button. But let's go back and let's set up automatic file upload for this channel. It's really a two-step process. The first step is for your channel, you need to enable automatic file upload. And you can see here it says excluded. So we want to change that. And here's the checkbox to enable automatic file upload. And I'm just going to click apply. The second part of the step is to go down to the configuration section and select automatic file upload. And you need to also enable automatic file upload right here. You can also choose the protocol of the server there that you want to send the files to. There's FTP, rsync, CIFS, SCP, SFTP, AWS, S3, and WebDAV that you can choose from. And you can also choose to download or upload files to the USB drive. Now, technically speaking, there are a couple of functions with the USB drive that are not automatic file upload, but we'll talk about that in a moment. Now you can see here there's an error message that's telling me that automatic file upload needs to be configured in another location in the UI, and that's because the USB has its own configuration tab, because there's a few other options, particularly having to do with being able to copy directly as soon as you plug in your stick, or manually copying files from the recording page onto the USB stick. And that's technically not AFU, but it's included with the same functionality. So we'll look at that in a moment. But while we're on this page, here's where you would set the interval of how often you want the files to upload. So you can choose every hour, every 6, 12, or 24 hours, or on file rotation. Now, file rotation means that whenever recording stops, the file is going to upload to the AFU location that you've chosen. So let's just keep it at every 6 hours. Now the other options you have here is to remove the file after upload. So basically once the file uploads, it's going to be deleted off of Pearl. You can mark the file as downloaded. And what that means is that in the recorded files list for your channel, the file is going to change color. And so you know that that file has uploaded. You can create a subfolder for each channel, and this is going to take the name of your channel and use that as a subfolder name on the server location that you've chosen or USB stick. What's important to note is that this selection won't cause any files to be deleted, because the actual files that are uploaded are given a unique timestamp, so they'll never be that worry. And you could also choose to create a subfolder for device, which means the serial number of Pearl is going to be used as the folder name. And if I wanted to, I could specify a remote path specifically here. And if the path doesn't exist on the server, it will be created when the files are uploaded. The other interesting thing on this page is the log of automatic file upload. So if I click Show Log, it's going to show me the files that have been uploaded. So because I've chosen the external USB drive, there is that one extra step that I need to do. I could just click this and it's going to do it automatically for me, but let's go take a look. And before I leave, let's just make sure we've clicked Applied. If I scroll down here, under configuration, you'll see external USB drive. I'm going to choose that. And this is what Perl would update for you if you had selected the fixed link. But there's a few options here that you're going to want to look at anyways. I can choose used for one time, move copy of the recorded files on insertion. So basically, as soon as I insert my USB stick or external drive into one of the USB ports on Perl, the files are going to upload that are in the queue, and that's it. They're going to do the one time. The other option is to manually move or copy the selected files via the web interface. And what happens here is you get a few other options, a few new buttons to click on the recording tab of your channel, and we'll be able to see that in a moment. And you can also use the automatic file upload method just by selecting that. And let's just click Apply. So what's going to happen now is when I connect my USB stick to Perl, when the interval meets its time, the files will automatically be moved and copied to the USB stick. Now, when it says move and copy, what that means is that the files are automatically deleted off of Perl once they've copied over to your USB stick. But let's change this to a manual move and copy and apply. Now, before I can actually start moving any files from the program recording page, I need to insert the USB stick. Okay, here you can see Perl 2, and all you need to do is insert your USB stick just like that. Now, you could insert it into the ones in the back as well. It doesn't really matter. Now, what I'd like to show you is that on the status page, so let's just click the gear icon and then click to go next onto the second page. And you can see here, it's the automatic file upload. Select that, and what you're seeing here is the status page. So you'll see the which protocol has been selected for the automatic file upload. You can see that how many files are in the queue and the total size. And now when I go to the recording page for my recordings that you want to download, and simply select your recording that you want to download, and you notice now that there are options at the bottom of the screen. If you choose to copy the selected files to the USB drive, then the files will copy over. If you move them, it'll actually copy them over and then delete them off of Perl. If you've set everything up and you don't see these options, make sure that you have a USB or an external drive plugged into Perl, and go back and take a look again, and they should be there. And that's it. I've showed you how easy it is to set up automatic file upload for different protocol server types, the different options that you have available, like using the serial number on Perl as a folder name or the channel name as a folder name. You can set the interval. You can also download files directly to a USB stick, either using automatic file upload or using a manual process. So like, subscribe, and we look forward to our next training session.